30 years ago, when his father obtained the government lease to start a farm in Upper Santa Cruz, Ken Rivas sought to follow in his footsteps, making his living out of farming. The young farmer turned to squatting on state lands, creating a farm on land not too far away from his father's plot. Today, he's a successful horticulturalist and agriculture farmer. But Mr. Rivas has been frustrated by the government's inability to regularize the land he occupies, despite numerous applications over the past 3 decades. The farmer says his situation shows the government's short-sightedness with regard to agriculture.
If the government look seriously here into agriculture, because no government to my knowledge has really looked into this process as how it's supposed to be done. We have youths. I train youths in agriculture, the youth program, and I just give it up because they're just going back. I see PEP and attendees and these kind of foolishness. It's not working for our country.
The farmer has now returned to his father's original plot, but is seeking to acquire more land to create more job opportunities for youngsters in and around the community. Mr. Rivas is no stranger to teaching youngsters agriculture, as he was a teacher at the Youth Apprenticeship Program in Agriculture for 3 years. Students of the University of the West Indies have also visited his farm for insight into agriculture. He believes agriculture can provide sustainable employment for many youngsters who may otherwise turn to crime, in addition to reducing the country's food import bill.
These CPEP work on them every time they're cleaning the road. They're cleaning the road like if it's weed, they're weeding it today. Get work for them. Proper work for them to do. Even serve that same morning shift that they're doing on the CPEP program today. That would help. You know how much that is if they go out and plant fields?
Mr. Rivas says his own success in agriculture is testament to the possibilities available. Despite being unable to access ADB assistance due to his lack of official regularization, Mr. Rivas was able to complete construction of a home for his family and is even able to pay workers to help him at his greenhouse.
I'm trying to create employment. I'm doing this for years. I'm always bringing in employment. Right now, I do it on a regular basis. Just 2 persons, 3 days a week. On a regular basis. Normally, I used to take in and out all the while until things progress. I always give people a little day work, 2 days work, until things progress to this stage today.
Mr. Rivas, who has been trying to gain regularization since 1987, says he last visited the Ministry of Food Production in 2012 after then-Minister Vasan Bharat called in all farmers occupying lands for more than 7 years to be regularized. But he left again frustrated as Karoni farmers were given priority. When contacted today, current Minister of Food Production, Devant Maharaj, said the issue now falls under the Ministry of Land and Marine Resources. CNews was unable to contact an official from that ministry for comment on the issue. Peter Christopher, CNews.